Hi friends, this is Viswanath, chemistry faculty. Now see the answers for forensic laboratory exam. At 300 Kelvin, 2 moles of an ideal gas expanded reversibly and isothermally from 20 bar to 2 bar. The work done by the gas during this expansion in kilojoules is. For this suitable formula, W equal to work done W equal to minus 2.303 nRT log P1 by P2. Substitute the values, minus 2.303 into 2 moles, N value 2, R value, universal gas constant, 8.314 in joules, into temperature 300 Kelvin, into log of P1 means 20, P2 means 2 bar. So log of 20 by 2, then W equal to minus 11,488.28 joules. In kilojoules, its value is minus 11.49 kilojoules. Then what is the option? Option A is the answer. Next, if a monoatomic ideal gas argon at an initial temperature of 500 Kelvin expands reversibly and adiabatically from a volume of 50 liters to 400 liters, the final temperature of argon in Kelvin is. Here, for monoatomic ideal gas argon, gamma value is 1.66. For reversible adiabatic expansion of gas, temperature volume relation is T into V power gamma minus 1 equal to constant. So from this we can write T1 V1 power gamma minus 1 equal to T2 into V2 power gamma minus 1. We have to calculate T2. Then T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 whole power gamma minus 1. Substitute T1, V1, V2 values and gamma value. Then we can get T2 equal to 125 Kelvin. Then what is the option? Option C is the answer. Next, the value of delta H at 300 Kelvin and 2 bar pressure for the reaction described by 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O in liquid state is minus 573 kilojoules. Assuming that the reactant gases behave ideally, delta U for the above reaction is change in internal energy. Delta U we should find out. Delta H equal to delta U plus delta NG RT. Here delta NG means difference in the number of moles of products and reactants. So product is in liquid state, we have to consider 0. 0 minus 2 plus 1, 3. So 0 minus 3, minus 3. Given delta H, how much? Minus 573 kilojoules. In terms of joules, value is minus 573,000 joules. Now delta U we want to calculate, that equal to delta H minus delta NG RT. Substitute all the values, then delta U we can get minus 565.5 joules. So what is the option? Option B is the answer. Next, the entropy change in isothermal reversible expansion of 1 mole of an ideal gas from a volume of 10 decimeter cube to a volume of 100 decimeter cube at 300 Kelvin in joule Kelvin inverse is delta S equal to 2.303 into NR into log of V2 by V1. Then substitute number of moles, that is 1 mole, R value 8.314, V2 means 100, V1 10. So substitute all the values, then we can get delta S 19.15 joule. Option is A. Option A is the answer. Next, mercury metric method is used in the titration of A in very dilute solutions using diphenyl carbazone indicator. What is A? Here, mercury metric method is used to identify the C. In this method, Cl minus ion, chloride ion is titrated with mercuric nitrate and diphenyl carbazone as indicator. In the given sample of the substance, chloride ion present or not, we can identify by using this mercury metric method. Option A is the answer. Next, what is the volume in milliliter of 0.1 molar ceric sulfate required to completely oxidize 50 ml of 0.02 molar oxalic acid? So we want to oxidize oxalic acid by using ceric sulfate. How much volume of ceric sulfate is required? We should calculate. Between these two, balanced equation is 2 into CeSO4 twice ceric sulfate plus 2 into C2H2O4. This is oxalic acid, gives rise to 2 into COO COOCe plus 2H2SO4. So suitable equation is M1V1 equal to M2V2, V2V1. Substitute values, V2 equal to 10 ml. In above equation, 2 moles of ceric sulfate, 2 moles and 2 moles of oxalic acid are participated. Therefore, required volume to oxidize this oxalic acid is 20 ml. Generally, students do mistake. Answer is 10 ml. That is wrong. Option, correct answer is 20 ml. So, what is the option? Option A is the answer. Next, say this. Arrange the following diazonium ions in the order of decreasing reactivity towards azo coupling reaction. So, towards azo coupling reaction, we should write the order for these diazonium salts. See this, 4 diazonium salts are given, ions are given. The more electron withdrawing group is in diazonium ion, then more is the reactivity towards azo coupling reaction. Electron withdrawing group is present, then the reactivity is more towards azo coupling reaction. See one by one. First, second ion. In this, at para position, NO2 group is there. It is a electron withdrawing group. This nitrite group present at para position, it exhibits minus psi effect, negative inductive effect, negative resonance effect, minus R effect. So it has the highest reactivity towards azo coupling reaction. Next, ion 4, this one. At para position, cyanide group is there. Cyanide, Cn minus, also electron withdrawing group. It has only one effect, minus psi, negative inductive effect. So its reactivity towards azo coupling is less than this one. Next, para methoxy. First ion, in this methoxy para position, methoxy group is there. It exhibits different effects, minus psi effect, negative inductive effect, and positive resonance effect. Plus R effect means positive resonance effect. And N dimethyl, 2 methyl groups attached to the nitrogen at para position in this ion. So it shows only positive effect. So highest reactivity, this NO2 group, and then CN, and then OME, and then this one. So what is the correct order towards azo coupling reaction? Second one greater than fourth one, greater than first one, greater than third one. Okay, so this is the answer. Next, identify the incorrect statement from the following about aldoses of D family. Alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are called C1 epimers. This is correct. D glucose and D mannose are called C2 epimers. This one also correct. D glucose and D galactose are C4 epimers. Option C also correct. D-galactose and D-mannose are called C4 epimers. This option is incorrect. This is not correct. So option D is the answer for this question. Okay, students.